were to show up. People, if you can hear us, please tell us.
Hello.
We're up. Awesome. Okay. I had video. Hello, folks. So we're back. We're going to be starting off with Seaman again. I believe last time we were there, most of them were dead. There was mass fratricide happening as they sucked each other's bodily fluids.
It was not a great time.
I'm pretty sure that the next sort of stage in evolution happens once there is only one Seaman remaining.
Cool, great.
So that's our goal
awesome.
For today. Oh, let me switch us over to the full screen. Oh, wait, that's not going to work. There, that's going to work. There we are. So let us know if the volume's not good. We always seem to have trouble with that, and we don't have a good way of testing it on our end. So if Leonard Nimoy is too quiet, let us know.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. First, a recap of your previous visit. The number of gill men has decreased due to natural selection. It seems cruel, but survival of the fittest is an integral part of their lives. At the moment, the habitat contains 2 gill men. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
Yeah, I'll press the start button. Commence the horror show.
I don't want to make them comfortable. They should be suffering.
I feel like suffering will do them good.
Due to natural selection is a turn of phrase.
There.
I'm scared of you.
There's a chance to fuck with that one.
Yeah, that's what it's gonna be.
Yeah, okay.
Bird.
Not heat it up. Heat?
Hello?
Don't think it understood me.
Yay! Woohoo! Yay! Yay! Goody! What are you doing?
It's fine. Don't worry about it.
Too warm.
Well, you'll have to just wait. I hope I have now not completely messed the whole thing up by overheating them.
I'm sure it's
fine. I'll pick it up out of the tank. That'll help it.
No, stop. I'm scared. I'm scared.
Use it to my use.
No,
yes,
stop.
Put it back. Don't touch strange things.
Okay. Oh, we should give them food also. Strange food pellet. I can remember how this interface works. It's like pinch, hold, exit inventory, let go.
Huh.
Well, they're eating at least, so it can't be that bad.
It can be that bad.
Yummy. It's hot.
Like food?
Do we need to do two pellets?
I don't think so. Anyways, you want one of them to die.
Yo!
I mean, ideally, I want both of them to die, but...
Fratricide.
Oi.
Claims to have recognized that. Hello? Hello?
Hi.
I've got a way to hold this so I can actually see the screen while I talk, so I can see whether it's recognizing stuff. What's your name?
Huh?
I promise, they look creepy in any lighting.
Oh, are people complaining about the creepy underlighting?
It's...
This is the only way they don't look creepy.
Yeah, that's a good look.
It's so dark in here.
Ghost story. Ghost.
It's hot.
Man, they sure can complain.
Too warm.
If I pump air in, will that cool it down? Is that how physics work? Story.
No, maybe I eat you.
I'll eat you.
Me.
You're ugly. Ugly. Ugly.
It's hot.
Ugly. Ugly. Oh my god, first generation texture recognition.
It's not great.
Not great, no. And I've got to like make sure I wait in between button pushes and saying things and letting go. It's very, like, CB radio style. Over and out. Sometimes it just doesn't seem to, like, know that I even tried to say something.
Huh.
Over and out. Seaman.
Huh? Too warm. Too warm.
And what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna, go forward a day so it's no longer warm. And then hopefully the other one will kill it.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Saying in the stream.
Nothing good.
Yeah, I'm realizing that.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. There is a definite pattern to your visits. It appears you are a punctual person.
So untrue.
At the moment, the habitat contains 2 gill men. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
Oh, that was us interrupting him.
Oh.
Ideal temperature is 19.9, and I think that'll make things happen faster.
So someone in the chat was wondering what Mute Saito has actually done recently, and he actually recently did an interview saying that he tried making apps for a while, and it wasn't working out money-wise, so now he's going to be working on a game again because he wants to get paid, and that's all he cares about, which is, like, really refreshingly honest.
I think a new Seaman for 3DS is the way to go.
Oh yeah, that'll make a ton of money. That's definitely.
Well, this was a hit. This is one of the big, better-selling
really?
Dreamcast games. I believe in Japan it was, at least.
When did it... Like, was it a launch title, or...?
It wasn't a launch title. I think it just, like, it hit a weird nerve.
Huh.
A very weird nerve.
An extremely weird nerve.
Like, to the extent that any game on the Dreamcast was a hit, so that
right.
doesn't mean that much. But, like, it did have a sequel.
Right.
Which I'm not sure what system the sequel was for. I just know it has cavemen in it.
Multiple people in the chat have suggested Seaman go because they are sinners in the eye of God and need to be cast out.
He did like these weird sort of ARG-like things around announcing Seaman originally, I think.
The chat says there's a viral marketing campaign
yeah.
where there are ads that look like Nature magazine articles.
Yeah, no. That doesn't seem like it would be that far off.
That... Wow.
I wonder what his apps were like.
It didn't sound super interesting.
He should just make pets. Hello? Hello?
You should feed it.
Oh yeah. Starting to get low on food pellets. Hello? Hello?
Ooh, I'm a fat boy.
Hello?
Oi.
Seaman.
You want Seaman?
I want Seaman. I want Seaman.
We do not want Seaman.
Die in a fire. Some trouble with it recognizing. Die in a fire. Fire! I'm never sure how close I need to be to the mic. It also originally had like a little foam ball on it, but that's basically rotted away. Seaman!
Yo!
Yo! Yo!
No!
Yes! Murder! Murder! Drink blood. Blood.
Listen.
You're cute.
False.
Yes.
The seaman disagrees with you. Red rum. Red rum. A sign that it's gonna that other one to show up. Let's talk. Let's talk.
Don't know what to say.
Water.
Huh?
Brother.
Pay attention.
Drink each other's blood.
I'm rubber, you're glue.
Die.
There are Seaman plush toys. No, that's not, don't make excited noises.
I think I need one in my life. How realistic is the face? What's up?
I thought you liked me.
I love you. Now die. I love you. I love you. I love you. This is the worst dating game.
They're not actually Seaman plush toys.
Oh.
That's good. I'm glad.
I love you, Seaman.
Seaman, Seaman.
Any sentence with Seaman, I think, just triggers the I heard the word Seaman. Let's talk. Let's talk.
Talk about what?
Bears. Bears.
Can you, like, try to pull them together?
Breathing fine.
I think we may just, like, need to talk with them enough for it to trigger. Or we need a few days. We should, like, skip ahead a day.
Stop. It's making me scared.
Now hang out together. Yes, hang out. Ooh, good sign.
Yeah, that's the bad luck.
Hi, guys.
Mimi.
I like you.
Hee hee.
Laugh. Die.
Not on an empty stomach.
Laugh. close.
They don't have individual faces, but they do have different expressions, so...
Oh, they don't actually care about the food. He said not on an empty stomach, though.
I think that's just his response to...
You lied. Don't lie to me, Seaman.
Bedtime?
Yes, check tomorrow.
Okay.
Would you like to save and end the session?
All of the faces are the face of the creator. Oops. Not save games. Settings. So we can safely skip a day.
Okay.
Let's try that and see what happens. What's the DreamWorks face?
That sort of smug.
Okay, yeah.
So named because I don't know if you've ever seen a DreamWorks 3D movie, but if not, you will do the work.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. It is good to have you back again. 2 days have passed since you last visited the laboratory. At the moment, the habitat contains two real men. There is not enough oxygen in the tank. Please give them more oxygen by utilizing the air supply. Allow me to give you the highlights for today. I'm not sure, but it seems that Seaman wants a name. Pay close attention to what he says. So let us head over to the tank.
Okay, chat, do we have a name? Do we have a name for Seaman? We need a name.
Is Abomination too long?
Might be. Oh, I like the tank when it's like this. You can't see the Seaman.
Ah, here we go. Ah, here we go.
That's a baby sound.
Oh, yeah. Ah.
What did I do to the chat? I don't deserve this.
Given how terrible the,
sweet, precious air. My fins are frozen. Do something. I'm freezing. I'm cold. It's really cold in here.
I didn't realize this would happen.
It's really cold in here. I'm freezing. I'm cold. Ugh, it's too cold in here. It's about time. Yay! It's about time. It's about time. Oh, goody. I thought I was a frozen Seaman for sure.
I really was not prepared for this.
Hmm.
Can you imagine if Furby talked like this?
Yes.
Hey, cut that out. I'm trying to get some sleep here. Wow. Now that's dark. Wow. Now that's dark. Mother, I'm frightened. Turn on the light. Hey, turn on the light. Hey, flick the light switch, will you? Hey, turn on the light. Ah, it's too bright.
At all.
Stop grabbing me. Oh. Oh. Let me go. Oh, you're crushing me. What are you doing? Stop it. Let me go. Oh. Oh.
Everyone needs a hobby. That's mine.
No thanks. I'm not hungry now.
Oh, weird. I expected him to be hungry after 2 days.
Does it just want to murder?
What?
Hi!
Well, you know I try.
Let's talk.
I'm impressed. I only went on sale very recently, and here you are taking care of me.
Oh.
I like a person who doesn't waste time.
Check the date.
Oh my god.
And since we said we're playing this in the year 2000. Nintendo.
Try Sega.
Sega!
It's rather difficult making out what's on the other side of this glass, so let me inquire. Are you a male or a female?
Which one to go with?
Well, it's you, so...
Male.
Come on, spit it out. Previously, I had a question for you. Now, what was it? Oh, yes. It's rather difficult making out what's on the other side of this glass, so let me inquire. Are you a male or a female?
Male.
You're a male of the species, eh?
Why is this analog?
Yes.
Well, I was hoping to meet a lady, but I guess I'm not in the position to be too choosy, am I?
Decision on the name.
We're ignoring the chat suggestions because they're terrible.
Okay.
And frankly, they all should be grounded.
Let's talk.
So I was led to believe I would be cared for by a fairly young, responsible human being. So far, this has proven to be true, but. I am wondering about your age now. Tell me, are you in your, 20s?
No.
Oh. Well, then perhaps you are a teenager. Is this correct?
No.
All right, I'm tired of guessing. How old are you, then?
None of your business.
All right, I'm tired of guessing. How old are you, then?
40.
You're 40 years old?
Yes.
Wait. Time out. I'm not feeling so good all of a sudden.
Rude.
What's up?
Rude. Rude.
Morning is over.
I love you.
I love you too, Pinky.
Let's date. I wonder if this thing... If I had made this, I'd make sure that it would have a whole routine for people trying to date the Seaman.
It's upsetting.
Yes, but humans are upsetting. Flowers.
No. But thanks for asking. No, really. Let's try this again. I said... So I was led to believe I would be cared for by a fairly young, responsible human being. So far, this has proven to be true, but I am wondering about your age now. Tell me, are you in your, 20s?
No.
Oh. Well, then perhaps you are a teenager. Is this correct?
No.
All right, I'm tired of guessing. How old are you then?
39?
You're 39 years old?
Yes.
Yes, a 30-something. The body doesn't feel as good the next day after a night of revelry. You can't stay up as late. It's tough growing old, huh?
This pet is rough.
It doesn't let you be over 39?
Apparently? Wow. Oh. Why do you hate me?
Sure, that's what they all say.
That sounds plausible.
I should realize, whenever it asks me a question, the controller beeps. I didn't realize you could use the VMU speaker.
Oh,
huh. Hardly anything does that.
Interesting.
But I didn't realize that the Dreamcast had a speaker before the Wii. The Wii did. Because I thought that was the first time a speaker showed up in the controller.
Same.
Talk to it about
murder.
Murder. Understand.
What's up?
You're up. Name. Name. Name.
You almost gave me a heart attack.
What's your name?
What's up?
What's your name?
I don't know.
Can I name you?
So, what month is your birthday in?
July.
You were born in July?
Yes.
Well, count back 9 months. It must have been a pretty chilly autumn. You can't blame your parents for trying to keep warm, but I can.
Ugly. Ugly.
Talk to the fin.
Fuck you, Seaman.
So, what day is your birthday on?
19th.
The 19th?
Yes.
Lizzie Borden was also born on July 19th. Just thought you should know.
I remember being cruel. I do remember just the level of cruelness. Asshole.
What?
Asshole.
How much voice did they record
for this? Don't make me take your temperature.
Oh, that's upsetting. I don't like that.
Why are you the worst? Why are you the worst?
Aw, shucks.
Sega. And I still won't respond to that. Nintendo.
I've been thinking about this, and if my calculations are correct, you must be a Cancer, also known as a Moon Child. Oh, great. Listen, I know you pay a lot of attention to what other people think, but try not to stay up all night worrying about it, okay? We both need our sleep.
I love you. Why won't you look at me?
What do you want?
Pony.
Oh, you almost gave me a heart attack. Well, I think that pretty much covers it. Later.
Do you want to quickly check a fact and see how we name it?
Yeah, sure.
Sony. PlayStation.
That name sounds familiar.
PlayStation.
That name sounds familiar.
GameCube.
No, leave me alone.
It claims to recognize both of those. Tell me about you.
Oh no, you're not getting off that easy.
Nautilus.
Not right now.
I didn't realize there was, like, backstory.
Oh, you're crushing me! Put me down!
Where's the other one? Hello. Yeah, the input window for this seems to be really annoying. Are you reading the backstory?
I'm trying to figure out when you name it.
It's like day two of one to it. We've just had a lot of trouble. I think they all have the same terrible, terrible personality. What's on your head?
Oh, you just need to say.
Oh, what do I say?
I will give you a name.
I will give you a name. I will give you a name. I will give you a name. I will give you a name. Oh man, this is corroded. Recognizes when it's asking questions, it recognizes.
Wait, is that just a regular microphone? Like, could you plug in another?
Yeah, I think we could just plug in another microphone. It's just like all I've got is USB microphones around.
Yeah.
Doesn't recognize me clicking at it. Fish. Fish. Weird. It's like not like, so on the screen it basically tells us whether or not it understood what we said, or whether it didn't understand. And right now it's not doing either, it's just showing me a picture of a frog human. Fish. Fish. Okay, there's one word we know it likes, which is Seaman. I'll try that.
Yeah.
Seaman.
Mother, I'm frightened. Can you turn the light on?
Oh!
Turn on the light.
And that's his father.
Oh, my eyes, my eyes, my eyes.
Seaman. Seaman.
What?
I will give you a name.
Okay, I'm going to let you give me a name. When you've decided what you want to call me, say, I'm ready.
What do we want to call it? I have a terrible idea.
Well, we know what the chat wants to call it.
Which is?
I don't like the
Maybe
chat.
Maybe this isn't the best
call
time.
Call it Trump.
Let's discuss this at a later
Seems
date.
Seems appropriate, right? I will give you a name. I will give you a name. I am ready.
Hey, why all the noise?
I will give you a name. I will give you a name.
Okay, I'm going to let you give me a name. When you've decided what you want to call me, say, I'm ready.
I'm ready.
All right, then. Here's how to do it. You're going to say my new name three times. Each time I say now, say the name once. Got it? Now.
Fido.
One more time.
Fido.
One more time.
Fido.
Okay, I'll remember that. Next time you want to call me using that name. And don't forget the name you gave me, 'cause if you do, I'm not going to tell you what it is. Well, I'll talk to you later, my friend.
Okay, let's go somewhere else in the tank and see if Fido will come. Fido. Fido. Fido.
Is it the microphone or?
I don't know. Like, it seems to be fine whenever it does. I think it's just the software's, like, it's trying to do voice recognition on a Dreamcast. Fido.
Hey, settle down there.
Shall we see what happens tomorrow and then call it for this week?
Would you like to save and end the session?
So you only name one of them, the other will not.
Yeah. Let's be clear, the other one is not long for this world. The Seaman's existence is a harsh one. Also, we get to hear what Leonard Nimoy has to say about this.
So, do one more day of Seaman?
Yeah. We'll see what this day brings, and then we'll switch off to SOS.
Cool.
And drown.
It's not true. We can also die in a fire.
This is true. We'll do both. The other one is definitely just as much of a joke. I'm pretty sure they have some sort of hive mind.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. Let's see. Last time, you have given a name to one of the gill men. His coloration has changed, so you should be able to locate him easily. Please, take good care of him. At the moment, the habitat contains 2 gill men. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
Okay. I think I realize then how this works. It now lowers it down to them only being 2 of them. And then at that point, we need to age it enough for it to get the adult voice. Once it has the adult voice, you can name it. Once it's named, now that we care about one of them, the other one will fall and die.
It's too cold here. I'm cold. What is it?
I'm trying to figure out what the coloration difference is. Oh, I see. One's gold.
I'm freezing. I'm cold. Ugh, it's too cold in here. I'm cold.
But the other one's
I'm
talking.
Cold. I'm cold.
I thought that was.
I'm cold.
Yes.
I can call for Fido and find out.
Yeah. Yay! Oh, goody.
Fido! Fido! Fido!
Hey!
How is it though?
Oh yeah, huh.
Okay.
How are you doing?
Someone over here wants to eat.
Understood. You vile creature.
The chat wants to know how the seamen reproduce.
Hey, thanks.
Is there any indication of that in the game?
I don't know. Like, we know their life cycle after that is fucking disturbing.
Hey, thanks for the food. I'm full now.
Fido!
Oh, are we gonna get some murder?
Oh, no.
Oh.
Fido! Fido! Oh, that is Fido, okay.
What do you want?
I love you. I love you.
No, leave me alone.
Tell me about you. Tell me about you. How is life? How is life? Kill your...
What?
Kill your brother.
Oh no, you're not getting off that easy.
Suggest some other things to say to it.
My stomach is growling. That was damned yummy.
Oh, the little happy flaps. You're adorable. I don't know what to make of when it doesn't, like, it doesn't register one way or the other. You're adorable. You are adorable. Oh, that's what I'm angry.
Well, you know I try.
You're a cutie.
Oh, you.
So cute.
Well, what a nice thing to say.
Ugly.
Talk to the fin.
How do you get to ask the questions?
Let me go. Drop me. Now.
You choose to. Nintendo? It just ignores me when I say those right now. I know that'll change eventually. Sega! Do you like food? Do you like food?
What do you want?
Do you like food?
Talk
to me. Talk to me.
No, I'm done for today.
I guess it doesn't want to talk to us.
Did you set the date for
me? I thought I did.
Would you like to save and end the session?
She doesn't show the day in the game. I can check.
Okay, well, try bumping it for us, I think.
Yeah.
While you do that, I am going to read out what the story of Seaman is, because this is wild.
Okay.
Once long ago, in Egypt's third dynasty, there was a man who fell in love with a priest's daughter. This man was the son of a pharaoh, who disapproved of his son's relationship with the priest's daughter. The priest seeked help from Duthi, who was the god of wisdom. He was depicted as a man with the head of an ibis bird, and carried a pen and scrolls upon which he recorded all things. Is shown as attendant in almost all major scenes involving the gods, but especially at the judgment of the deceased. Duthi had turned the man and his lover into a fish creature and a bird. The man became a fish, and his lover became a bird. Both had vanished. The priest, by the time, was in charge of the construction of the pyramids, as to the, if they would ever return. The pharaoh asked that the priest could build a landmark that could act as a beacon, so that one day the couple could return. Thousands of years later, Professor William Sutherland, director of the Archaeological Research Institution in France, had announced to the international media that there was a strong possibility that the creature Seaman was very much related
to the origin of the ancient Egyptian civilization. There is a definite pattern to your visits. It appears you are a punctual person. At the moment, the habitat contains two gill men. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
Later, a man named Jean-Paul Gasset was the first scientist to discover the Seaman creature, or to research the Seaman creature, and is, in a sense, this creature's discoverer. Gasset found himself in an expedition around the area of the Nile River.
My fins are frozen.
Investigating the biological ecosystem of the river.
My fins are frozen.
Gasset found mutated bone fragments.
Yeah, that's good.
All of the bone fragments share common characteristics. They all seem to have mutated suddenly, and over a short period of time, in order to adapt to the change in metal. The fragments correlated with hieroglyphs found on the ruins of pyramid walls dating back to the ancient Third Dynasty. While trying to reproduce Seaman's region and environment, Gasset continued making experimental mistakes
in
the lab-based aquarium. Gasset realized that Seaman was no ordinary creature.
His
creature states is just like human beings, then gave him a name, Seaman, or Man of the Sea.
It's too cold in here. Ugh, it's too cold in here.
And that is apparently the backstory of Seaman.
Yeah, I believe that does come into play. People are talking about it. The twist is it has genetic memory.
Yay!
Just in time. My gills were starting to freeze together. You know, I could really eat.
If you must.
We're probably gonna start running out of food.
Yeah.
Oh, yummy baity goodness. Good food. My compliments to the chef. Hello? Are you listening?
Yes. Let's talk.
I don't want to.
I love you.
Ugh. Spare me the mush.
I love you so much, why don't you kill your brother?
What?
Seaman? Just die already.
If you're happy, Seaman's happy.
I am not happy.
What's the matter?
You disgust me. You disgust me so much. You're like the grossest thing.
What do you want?
Talk. Progress.
Remember to chew.
Let's talk. Did it just do something?
I think it just...
Let's talk. Talk to me.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Talk to me. Talk
What do you want?
Talk to me?
No, I'm done for today.
Fuck this thing.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Hopefully next week, fratricide.
Okay. Yeah, I was looking at the walkthrough, and that's a lot of fucked up shit.
If I remember right, murder is not the next disturbing thing on the agenda.
Well, like, next we have to grow bugs.
Ah, okay.
Defeat it.
But it needs to still mutate one step before that.
No, it sounds like the mutation comes after.
Okay. Do we do need to run out of food then?
Hopefully it gives us caging around the same time. They might starve to death. We might have used up too much food.
We'll find out.
We can help.
Okay.
And now for SOS.
Let's swap things around.
Where's the headphone cable thing?
Headphone cable thing is, yeah, that. There. People are asking to see the first 5 minutes of Lady Killer.
If they want to see the first 5 minutes of Lady Killer, it's not going to be very exciting because it's all placeholder right now.
There's a series of question mark graphics showing up.
It's real exciting.
On one of the things I've been working on, if it gets like a false thing, the template is just flashing letters going, this is a cool thing. It's like a chest pops open and it's just like, this is a cool thing. This is a cool thing.
Oh, we do have a chest that pop, but it works in a very different way. Okay.
SOS. Keeps on suggesting disaster report when I put that in, and I kind of want to replay that.
That would be
to the end.
Cool. Is it getting video?
Not yet.
Okay.
Give me a second. I need to switch the
sure.
video over to not being. Oh wait. Okay. Unplug that. Configure video. Sorry folks, you need to change a bunch of little settings whenever we switch over to the laptop. Done.
Oh, it's on the TV now.
Laptop, I need to just deactivate and activate to get it to center properly. Still not centering properly. We've got Christine's laptop.
Is it showing? Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, it's not updating.
Oh, so. Also, like, it's not taking up the right amount of space. Is that the right profile?
No, I expect it to do that.
Oh, okay.
It's usually I need to restart it to get it to fix itself. Activate.
Oh, chat reminds me I need to pull up the map for SOS.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna let you take the controller on this because you're slightly better at the terrible jumps now.
Yeah. I'm okay with that. Getting better.
Let us know if there are any issues with the audio on this because it's different.
Yeah. song endlessly, but I don't have the option if I need it.
Music too loud.
You know what? Turn it down first on the laptop.
Yep.
It's crazy loud on the headphones.
How's that on the headphones?
It's good.
Okay. How's that on the stream?
Is that better? We can turn it way down if people want for this. We just shouldn't definitely need to turn it all up for BS Zelda.
Yep.
Oh, it stopped making noise anyways. Let's get in and we can adjust it.
Yep.
So who am I going to play as? So for folks who haven't seen this,
play as Luke Hines.
Luke Hines, okay. Luke Hines. So for people who haven't seen this before, it's basically takes place over a real-time hour as a ship sinks, and is a sort of Prince of Persia-style platformer. Only as the ship sinks, it also rotates at specific times, which makes it a very bad Prince of Persia platformer. The mix of weird, unclear graphics with very, very precise, almost unsteerable jumping.
So this is the crew member character. So I think he has a map. This is an actual game for the Super Nintendo.
Also, while it isn't exactly permadeath, dying takes off 5 minutes off the real-time timer. So this will not take an hour, almost guaranteed.
Because we're bad at the platforming and there's a lot of difficult platforming segments.
And unfair chairs.
Ship layout is always the same. The thing that changes is you have secondary objectives in the form of there are people you rescue for extra points. So certain characters need to rescue certain other characters, generally like their family members.
There's also multiple characters, so like
yeah.
You start at different spots with different objectives with each of them, and some don't seem to have access to a map. I don't have a map yet, at least.
It's solved.
Yeah, I tried. What's my position, do we know?
I think you have to go down.
Oh, there. I forgot the door opening.
Yeah, you have to press a button to open doors, which
can get
weird. Including in the air.
Yeah. Begins.
Here we go.
Okay, people are talking about random generation. Random generation wouldn't really work well with this type of gameplay because it's about loaning the routine. Like loaning what at what point what parts of the ship will be accessible. Since the rotations are set.
Yeah, no, this is very much about, like, learning the layout and, like, getting used to it, and then sort of, as you have learned the layouts, you can go and, like, complete secondary objectives.
It's more Majora's Mask than roguelike.
But also, someone in the chat's correctly identified there's not enough RAM in on the Super Nintendo to actually do random generation.
Hmm.
Because an important part of the game is backtracking. Backtracking, but also, like, storing states, so...
SOS, I'm upside down. Please send help to upside down world.
If you press select, do you get the map?
Oh, let me see. Yes, I do.
Okay, so first things first, turn it upside down.
Go. One of the best features about this game.
That's pretty good. Okay. So, I have no idea where you are.
I'm somewhere along.
Oh, you're that blinking red dot, probably.
Where is the blinking red dot?
Top right. Okay,
oh,
I'm gonna go look for the
upside down.
Map.
Yeah. No, that can't be where I am, because I'm.
Oh.
I'm near the top of the ship.
Are you?
I think that might be my objective.
Oh, maybe.
Yeah, we still haven't figured out. I wonder if it's doing frame skipping and...
It shouldn't be doing frame. I don't think
and
so.
And I'm off by that one frame, so it doesn't show us. Yeah, try something. Off chance I can sync it to the frame skip. No. Okay.
No.
So that's the control room, like where I start at the very beginning.
Okay.
I can go to the captain's area.
So if you give me a second, I'm gonna pull up
Oh, there's the captain.
Oh, cool.
Communication? Don't mind if I do. Captain's just freaking the fuck out.
Well, we're gonna ignore him and also
yeah.
Everyone else and just let everyone else drown.
Oh, that's not the... Oh, that's the captain. I thought the guy in red was the captain. Boris, get it together. You're dead. I can steer the ship from here. I'll get us back to port. So yeah, we're basically starting at the bottom of the upside down ship, or the top of the right side up ship.
I'm trying to figure out where you are. Keep going.
I think I know.
Okay.
Roughly. Yeah, I just went zigzag.
Well, move to the upright end.
Upright? Oh. Okay. Oh shit, is this already the boiler room?
No.
No. Oh no, this is like the stack, smoke stacks or whatever. How do I climb up? Oh, is that just like a background ladder?
Yeah.
Fuck you, background ladder.
It's...
Why do you even exist?
That's a good question.
So I'm in the second one of those.
Yeah, okay. Go up to the top.
Oh, I can't go into... Whoa! Okay. So it was the first of the rotations.
Yeah, so this is why... This is a terrible section. It's just absolutely horrible.
Oh, Jesus. No.
I know, right? Unfortunately, you must.
Let's lose a bunch of 5 minutes.
You're actually at a good angle for this.
Oh, fuck, fuck, fuck! Oh.
Well.
First 5 minutes lost. Still talking about the random generation on a console.
Yeah.
I imagine you could do it if the generating was really, really fast, because you could just use the same seed and save the seed.
Yeah.
But the generation would have to be really fast, so you couldn't do anything that was very... Fuck!
Someone's bringing up Shearing the Wanderer, which doesn't really apply because it does that per floor. You can't actually go up a floor.
It also was... What was the first system it was on? Because I thought it was like the DS, or was it? Is it?
That was the first one that we got.
Okay, yeah. I've been wanting to pick up the one on Vita for that, because I've never played them, but I've heard Reagan and Mayer, who made N Plus, are big fans of it and said good things.
Okay.
Okay, let's see if this is the right spot to do that jump from. Oh yes. Phew. Fuck you, shitty principal. Oh, fuck off! See, it's not technically Prince of Persia, you do have a little bit of air steering, but, like, this game would have been so much better with a lot of, like, forgiving air steering. Given all the other things that go against you in platforming. Like the fact that judging distances when everything is on an angle and you've got pixel precise grabbing. Oh, I can't climb up.
Wait,
that.
Doesn't matter. Just go
up.
Yeah,
I go this.
Just jump over the.
Let me see if I can jump to the next area. Doesn't matter. I've got to do it now.
God damn it.
I know, like, you set up this theme to be real-time games, but I think it's just games that troll me.
Maybe a little bit.
I think no other game has made me feel as self-conscious about my age as fuck! Seaman.
You can't climb up the left side because there's a door in the way. You can do it when it's at an angle.
Which
so,
we briefly were.
Blew our chance.
So given how hard this platforming bit is, we may have a very short...
This
SOS
may be extremely short.
Oh, fuck off! Fuck!
Well...
Yeah, trying to, like, because the hang spot is really, really precise, like, it's more precise than it should be.
Now we're flooding. Okay, now I can just go out the left.
Okay. Oh, I definitely can now.
Yeah. So, I think it actually is fairly forgiving in that way, because, like, you can't even get into the boiler room until, like,
Yeah, okay.
Keep
jumping?
Yeah. It's like you can't even get to the boiler room until the 30-minute
mark.
Keep
jumping?
Go
no.
down.
Okay. Please don't drop me down a giant pit.
Okay, good.
Okay,
you are
we're
now
already
going
here,
to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is easier than the other person we did.
It's possible we just actually went in the right direction. Now go up, up, up left. Yeah, through there. Now go left again.
Okay. Oh! That's funny, the landing on platform stuff isn't bad, but the grabbing shit is just terribly. The hitbox on it is incomprehensible.
Yeah, go up.
Oh, that was helpful. I really hope it doesn't suddenly tilt back in a second.
Now left.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, no, I don't think this would be good randomly generated. I feel like, if you played this enough to memorize the ship,
yeah.
That's already a lot.
If anything, I feel like making it easier to memorize by having a smaller ship.
I definitely feel that. Like, this game could stand to have less content.
Or have, like, a series of ships that you could do that were increasing in size.
Yeah, that would work.
Okay, I can swim through here. I did it last time. I love that the way that the tilting and the water and such change your access to areas.
That's really good, and I wish it
happened. Oh, fuck. Okay. Okay, open door.
This is pretty bad.
And now I've got to deal with the worst hitbox in the game, which is the... No, no, no. So it has, like, a little bit of drift when I do this type of jump. But I don't actually know if I can do it from this angle.
Well, eventually the water's gonna rise.
Yay!
No, that's good, because it'll,
No, 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 no. Shit!
Yeah, there's no music anymore.
Okay, we're 20 minutes left. I've got to open the door again.
Cling, hold on to something. It's going to rotate.
Okay. Which way? Do we
I don't know. But it's shaking, so.
Oh, thank God.
Wait, that was after 5 minutes. Jesus. Okay.
Well, there could have been one of those mini shifts in the meantime. Okay, I think I go up
yeah,
here.
Yeah, go up.
I can't believe I am starting to learn the layout of some
yeah.
of these areas. This is one of the more distinctive areas.
Yeah, and this is right before the boiler room.
Yeah.
Where are you now? Although, like, definitely you need someone navigating for you. Right here, definitely.
Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, it is a good co-op game. In the have one person navigating.
I mean, if the map was better, that would be fine.
Oh yay, this. Okay, how does this work again? This is like a totally stupid thing because of their shitty hitbox. I need to go down, up, jump. Down, up, jump. Trust me, folks, I do actually need to do this.
Okay,
think I can.
Oh shit! Shit!
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry for you.
I am getting better at this game. Sadly, this is what better looks like. Rotation, as far as we know, doesn't depend on the room, it depends on the time.
Is it gonna spawn us?
I don't know what's happening. Huh.
Okay, cool.
We're
just seeing a black screen here too. It's
Oh wait.
Oh no. It's just my screensaver's twitchy.
Yeah, we've gotta figure that out.
Okay. I thought I'd turn that off. That was actually not in the game for once.
Yeah, maybe
it was just some bad timing.
While we're explaining BS Zelda, maybe we can have a look and see if we can figure out what's causing that.
Yeah, I don't know, because I'm totally turned off my... there are benchmark goals,
why does that not...
No, it's true. There's... Escaping is not... I think escape isn't supposed to be too hard. Like, Okay, we're actually not going to do it this time.
Yeah.
That's...
I am getting better, but...
I mean, the problem is just, like, the platforming sucks. Just,
yeah.
Just straight up.
It's very precise, physically, but very imprecise, in terms of the visual feedback.
Yeah.
Because of the fact that it can be on weird angles, and it's got very, like, complex textures.
All right.
Ooh, the prettiest looking part of the game.
Oh, it's...
Well, it's gonna be an asshole to me.
Yeah, because the prettiness blocks your vision. Okay. So you wanna go...
I wanna go...
Oh, wait, you can grab onto that, though.
Can I?
Or maybe...
No, that's not the stuff I can grab onto.
Okay.
So I need to go
You need to drop
down.
Directly down.
Yeah. Oh, nope.
Not that directly. Well, cool.
Yeah, this was a fast one. Oh yeah, that's how we got here last time.
No, keep going up.
Oh, keep going up? Okay. I seem to remember hiding stuff. Oh, fuck off.
Well, good stream.
Yeah, we made it to the boiler room faster in terms of hour time, much slower in terms of game time. So we had a lot more time for me to fuck that up last time.
Okay, let's get Zelda going.
Now, it's an interesting game in that, like, with a bunch of things outside of its interesting ideas retuned, I think it would be a great game. But, like, the platforming's not great. There's a lot of things that are just unforgiving. It's really hard to navigate. So we should explain this, because last time we had some new players who were definitely confused about what's going on.
So... This was played on the Satellaview. You would download it from a satellite radio station. It was split into 4 weeks. So this is the original Zelda with different dungeons, and the content is sort of like people would play. You could basically play an hour a week.
And it would be at a specific time.
A specific
like 6
time.
O'clock, I can play the next episode of BS Zelda.
And there was specific like audio content that went with it that was timed to it. So everyone would be playing this at the exact same time during that hour.
And would only have that hour.
And there's sort of like preset like events that happen during the course of the game.
Yeah, and so the interesting thing is that while it has real-time audio, they don't know what time, where you might be in the map when that happens. So they have to sort of come up with all these like game-changing elements that don't count on you being at a specific point of the game.
But it also has like hints, so you know, if you're really behind, you can sort of catch up, because
yeah.
you only have 4 hours to play Zelda. One.
So we're 2 episodes in, but last episode we only did one of the 2 dungeons
yeah,
we had.
Really behind.
So we have to do 3 dungeons plus get us another special artifact.
Yeah.
Plus whatever the special artifact is for this.
So this is going to be a pretty tense
time.
Alright, well let's...
We may have to tune audio. We might want to turn the audio up
yeah.
a little bit for people.
I did turn it up. Please let us know if the audio is too quiet, because the narration is important.
Yeah, the narration's super important. Oh, it actually had tips there.
Yeah.
Welcome back once again, hero. Now, you must collect 2 more Triforce pieces. Once more, they are inside 2 of the Evil King Ganon's dungeons. Our goal is to have 6 pieces of the Triforce in total at the end of the battle today. You should have obtained a rat back in the 3rd dungeon. With that, go east towards the sea. It has come there now, without any fierce whirlpools. I can see an entrance to a dungeon there. So, let's get going. I will help you out from here, as usual. Hurry, hero. Give it your best, for your time is limited. Regain the 2 Triforce pieces before the land disappears. Now, take your sword.
Yeah, so this was originally broadcast in Japanese only, and this is a fan dub that...
Let's begin this week with a recap of the controls. To use the sword, press the A or Y button.
Okay, so where am I going?
Take a look at what happens when pressing the X button.
We need to go...
Can I finish the 3rd dungeon?
The subscreen.
You finish the 3rd, you
what is used
need to do the 4th, and we need to get the better
for
sword.
For example, the B button can be set to use the boomerang, bombs,
have a look
at
what we have to do.
Flute.
Yeah.
Try other items when they're added.
This is showing us what our inventory should look like at the end of this hour.
Well, this week began with the old man talking about the
world
of peace.
And that's what happened.
I already have the raft and have seen them. If not, go to the sea in the east. But wait, you can't go to the level 5 dungeon unless you have the raft. The only way to obtain this is to challenge the level 3 dungeon.
Okay.
That dungeon can already be found
somewhere
in this region.
Yeah.
If you look at the map, you'll surely understand where it is. However, not all dungeon entrances are visible.
And there's also in the desert, there is the,
I think we need the ocarina for that.
Okay. That makes sense.
We know which gravestone... It's not pushing.
Have you already
I think,
oh, right, yeah, I remember.
The B button? The boomerang stops the movement of any enemy it hits. It can also grab things that are beyond your reach. Bombs can be used to break walls as well as defeat enemies. It is said that there are breakable walls and cliffs above ground. In particular, the level 2 dungeon entrance can only be opened with a bomb. You can also break the statues in dungeons to find missing rooms. The candle can illuminate darkened rooms. It can also be used to burn any tree which blocks your path. Have you still not figured out the locations of the dungeons? The level 3 dungeon is in the southernmost area of the forest. The level 4 dungeon is up by the shore of the lake.
So the reason it's telling us these things is because it's trying to make sure that we have a chance to catch up, given we're behind. So it has sort of a time-based hit system.
Is your fight difficult, hero? A merchant is selling medicine across the sea, besides the level 5 dungeon. It is a valuable medicine that recovers life. It would be good to obtain it.
So that might be a hint, but it also might be a timed event.
Yeah.
Sometimes things are only for sale for certain times during the real-time clock.
You will need the raft across the sea to the east, past where the whirlpool was, in order to reach the level 5 dungeon. You can obtain the raft in the level 3
dungeon. Oh, I don't have any bombs.
Okay, then I'll go outside and, Well, we're already off to a great start.
Oh yeah, this is around the side. Oh, I think it may have been a shop at
The entrance to the dungeon, which you used the raft to reach, is not visible. There is just a suspicious grave. The evil king's power must be at work here. You're looking at an illusion. What appears to be a cliff is actually nothing. Let's experiment. Try walking into the cliff.
Remember that for later. Oh, god damn it. Oh, it doesn't actually hurt you. Okay, that's good.
Oh my god, are they doing a samba potion?
They sure are.
In this world, it is necessary to use rupees as money to buy things from merchants. Can acquire some by defeating enemies. There are some things merchants are selling that you should buy. For example, the magical shields are stronger than the ones you currently have. They can block the bullets Zora's fire from across the water. Arrows need a bow to be used. The bow should be found in the dungeon. The candle can burn trees, but it is also necessary to illuminate darkened rooms. Get the ring to reduce damage from enemy attacks. All that is known about the meat is that some monsters like it. However, it is a mystery why merchants are selling it.
So I realized another reason that it might be, telling us.
How are you fighting, hero? I shall try using the spell of lightning again.
Yeah, go back.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Fuck him up.
Excellent. I was realizing one of the reasons that it says so much stuff that you'd expect to just read in a manual is this probably did not have a manual, so it was a download game.
Yeah.
So it's probably their solution to not having a manual. Maybe through that bombed area? What's the red flashing?
I think that's the entrance. Oh wait, no, it's not.
Yeah, that's probably me.
Sword shine in your hand? Meet the old man at the graveyard if you do not have it. To reach the cemetery, exit the forest from the west and go north from the desert. Then push the gravestone in the middle. If you have enough life, you should get the powerful white sword. From the start, when you enter, is real. All the illusions are sure to disappear if the real one is defeated. It's easy to tell the real one in a crowd. The real one doesn't fly diagonally.
Oh. Okay, that's...
Do you think we need the arena for that sword, or...? Sound like we maybe should get the
yeah.
one to go diagonal.
Yeah. That's good.
The medicine sword near level 5 is blue. Actually, a red medicine which has the effect of being two blue medicines also exists. An old woman who lives somewhere in this land handles them. But the old woman's cave is hidden in the cliffs.
I bet you there's somebody to talk to along there.
The old woman has been forced into hiding within a secret cave, surrounded by the flying
flower
monsters known as pea ants. A letter is required to buy medicine from the old woman. The letter is given by the old man living by the East Sea.
It made a sound when you did that. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, push it was in the middle, and the voiceover just says it was in the middle. Oh, it's supposed to be in the middle, the grave.
Level 1 dungeon. The entrance to this can be found without difficulty. It contains the bow. If you can find the right block to push, be sure to obtain it. Level 2 dungeon. This place is in the huge rock beside the cliff to the northeast. You can't find this entrance without breaking the rock with a bomb. If you kill all the boomerang using Gorilla, you can obtain one for yourself.
Nope, that was
also,
the only one that doesn't give us.
There are rooms separate from
the
rest
the
which you can see on the map of the dungeons. To get
that's
to
the only one
you
that
need
doesn't
to be,
actually,
break the walls
oh.
with bombs.
Okay.
Level
Weird.
2 dungeon. This place
oh.
is south of the forest. Obtain the raft here. There is a secret to the room where you see the key in this dungeon. Think about where to go from that room in the south, where you see the key, but can't obtain it. There must be a bomb in a nearby room. It is possible to take it with the boomerang. That bomb is also necessary for going to the old man's room in the labyrinth, next to that. Level 4 dungeon.
I just gave us a tip
this
on the bit
This place is
stuck
by
in.
The lake
yeah.
north of the forest. It's possible to get past the pier if you have a raft. The flute can be obtained here. There is a block that can't be moved until all the enemies
okay.
are defeated.
That was a clue
if
we need.
If you spot it, the flute will surely be obtained. The Triforce room is located near the entrance, but you need to find it from the back room, so don't rush.
There's, So what he said was that there's, a a room where if you defeat all the enemies, then you can push a block.
Yeah.
But only then.
Hero, I have seen that fearsome vision again. A figure that strides on, enveloped in smoke, destroying monsters, rocks, and walls. And once more, I strongly feel the power of the stars that guide you. That power shall reach you through my body.
Oh, infinite bombs.
Nice.
Look at the number of bombs on the screen. It seems that the time has come for infinite bombs. Try using all the suspicious walls and cliffs. Located in the level 5 dungeon. It can cross rivers and moats, though only small ones. Do you remember the river where the peanuts live? You can proceed past that from the ladder.
Yeah, the red.
Yeah. Oh!
There we go.
We just had to kill every end. Okay,
yeah.
Great. That was stupid.
I thought last time it showed the key on the enemy. I feel like it taught us one thing in a previous bit, and then changed the rules on us. Which, honestly, inconsistency that only Zelda does not surprise me.
Oh wait, I could have killed all those guys with bombs.
To remember that there is a heart container somewhere in the East Sea. Go to where it is if you have the ladder. This should turn the tide of the fight in your favor.
We do not have time for light legs. Yes, infinite bombs.
Cross the sea in the east from the pier.
No.
Find the suspicious grave and go directly north from the grave. You don't need a bomb for this.
Yeah, I think the red link is the boss. And that's how we'll get the Triforce.
Maybe. Yeah.
And then
it's saying that we need the flute first, though.
Yeah.
No, I wouldn't.
In the dungeons, you must have seen the round skulls, the bubbles. These are the most annoying enemies. Although they don't hurt you with their touch, they render you unable to use your sword temporarily. In particular, if you touch a red bubble, your sword is disabled permanently until you touch a blue bubble. Beware these enemies the most.
Oh, that's why it has a flute.
Who eats your shield as well. Do not be careless around them.
Yeah, that's like kill the light legs.
See if the flute helps.
probably about the boss.
It seems your uphill battle continues. I will try to help with the spell of lightning.
Never mind.
Hita!
Just take care of him.
Yeah. Wait, why did I pick that up?
Zeldas?
They're in Link's Awakening.
Okay.
I don't know if they're in this one or in Zelda 1, but I probably...
I wonder if they're post, Whoa, it's a beholder. Oh, cool. We've got the gold.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh shit, I should have used it on the bottom screen.
Yeah.
Shit, I goofed.
Oh,
I got
Famicom Zelda by screaming into the mic.
Oh.
Oh, so they might also be weak to the Ocarina.
Yeah.
I wonder if they're post, if this is post Secrets of Mana, and there are off-brand rabbis.
I think it, well, apparently they're in the originals.
Okay.
Seems to have faded. It no longer flows in me.
I just lost infinite bombs.
The power of infinite bombs is lost. From here on out, we no longer be so curious about their use.
Thank you.
see the Ocarina here won't do anything, right?
If that's what makes it smaller.
Yeah, I was wondering if we would hold it again.
Nope.
No? Okay.
Jesus. Recording.
Yeah. No, mostly I'm just like, Jesus, about how fast they are compared to you.
Oh, yeah.
Do you hear me, hero? I am uneasy about how the falling rocks that always scared those traveling to the northern Rocky Mountain have stopped. It probably means that something unknown awaits. Hurry, your time is almost half past.
Oh.
Yeah, we're not doing great. And this is last week. We're halfway through,
yeah.
We caught up with last week. Great, cool.
Let's see, 15 minutes of dungeon, including finding out.
It has been said by people who have escaped the fallen rocks that there was a mysteriously lucky old man in the northern Rocky Mountains. Also, further west, there are eerie armor statues lined up in place. It has been handed down in old tales that bad things happen when these statues move.
Okay, so what are we doing now?
Oh, we've done all of this. We've got the sword.
Yeah, yeah. I was trying to go north, but I don't think.
Yeah, we need to go back to the original starting area and go north on one of the things, I think.
Okay.
Now that we have the map.
There we go. I feel like we're taking less damage now, which is great. This is my job.
Down to half. The entrance to the level 6 dungeon hasn't been found yet either. You must feel impatient.
Okay, so around here somewhere there's a bit we need to raft.
Hero, I've finally acquired a new spell. I was able to touch the fountain of life that flows through the earth. Oh, how wonderful. Let me send the power of the earth to you. However, it will not last for long.
We can be invincible.
In the meantime, it is a good idea to challenge some dungeons while your defenses are high.
Oh, shit. Oh, wow.
You now have a total of 16 parts. Starting from the moment of the old man's speech, this ability will only last for 10 minutes.
No, we're done here.
It will be difficult for you to die even if you act irrationally. However, you still need to be wary of the amount of life you have left. If you become careless, then you may still be defeated.
I think it's up from here. Okay.
Yeah, I think something's
stopped
doing damage a while ago.
Well, straight up that blue ring.
Yeah.
I don't think we need to go into any caves. I think it's about taking a raft.
Yeah.
We should find a raft. There's one of the rafting areas.
Yeah. Can't raft here.
Weird. Well, try using your boomerang to get it.
Oh, yeah. Nope.
Nope. There, there's
okay.
A...
Cool.
Oh, maybe we get to it from the other side.
Oh, maybe.
Okay, this is all new areas now.
Yeah, this is all new.
So we're now into this chapter's hour. Or area.
Climb a cliff behind the grave soldier's guard.
We need the ladder, someone's saying.
Okay. I assume that's probably a dungeon item.
Yeah. It's one of the ones we're supposed to get this.
The merchant who is selling medicine in front of the level 5 dungeon appears to have sensed danger.
Oh, come on!
I think we're... Phone it with fire!
Oh yeah, right. Okay, let's try it again.
I am so shocked. Play money-making game fast. Okay, good, we got money.
Cool.
Okay, good.
gotta keep moving.
Yeah, I agree with the statement.
Oh, there's a grave.
As I have lived, such an event is unprecedented. I see the entrance of a dungeon appear in the swaying waters. A comforting tone is heard with the sound of the waves.
At last, a clue to where the level 6 dungeon is. It seems to appear from the sea with a sweet sound. Do you love the flute?
I guess that's not the strongest sword. Dungeon?
But wait. Exactly what sea is being indicated here? It doesn't appear to have been the sea to the east.
Am I bombing around here? Maybe
there is
way
not
to
a sea to the
it.
West. The remaining coast is only
Let's
in the southeast.
Let's try that. Okay. Oh, this is the one that soldiers are guarding.
Ah, okay.
So what? Oh, except it was use a ladder, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure, but
that was the hint?
I can't remember. Anyone remember what the hint was for this bit? Try shoving it in different directions.
Hero. I shall use the spell written in the chapter of fate from the forbidden tomb.
I think that's gonna take us back to some other spot. It takes us back to they explained this last episode. It takes us back to the last
damn it
thing we explore.
Oh fuck. Okay. I did.
Hints during the time that we
damn
were
it. Yeah.
Trying to figure out. So yeah, try some bombs around here and see if anything works.
Oh. Yeah, right. There was a hint about. Except that's not really that helpful.
Hero, I shall use the spell written in the chapter of fate from the forbidden tomb.
Oh, okay.
shoving one of the statues.
No, you don't need a ladder.
Okay.
Just climb up.
Oh yeah, there's that whole bit about just walk through the wall.
Okay, thank you for Chad for paying more attention than we were.
Let one of them hit you. Can you just
Okay.
Yeah, there's like the one color and then you're gonna get hit by the other color. They explained that like 2 episodes ago, I think. No, it really does actually want you to be paying attention to all the little hints it gives.
Yeah.
They're not just...
Well, I mean, also like this is like, it assumes that everyone's played Zelda.
It seems the spell the old man received from the Earth has disappeared. From here, you must fight using your power alone.
Why didn't that give me full... Did fairies not give full health in this?
more hurt.
Do not overexert yourself, hero. With my remaining power, I may be able to provide something. Except this.
The magical boomerang has appeared in your hand. This powerful weapon can cleave enemies in half.
Nice.
In a hit. Use it with the B button.
Okay. Now.
Oh yeah, usually at this time it's actually like a negative thing. I guess they decided we were having a bad enough time.
I wonder if they were able to collect stats on how people had done.
Oh! Yeah, maybe everyone was just doing so poorly that
they're like, oh shit, okay.
Everyone needs some help. I don't know if it actually transmitted any data though. Like, so like the way that people submitted their high scores was just by like actually like sending them in. Like physically sending them in. So they might
like
not
a
have
disc
been
with their high score?
Or just like, you know, it was either I'm not sure if it was a code or just like send a photograph. I know a photograph is like how Nintendo Power did it. But
it's jazz hands again.
We're not seeing a cleave in here.
More of a beeping. Okay.
Oh. Shit. Wait. Is it a... Dongo was a boss.
It is possible. You have returned from the level 6 dungeon. Don't forget, you can obtain the magic rod from the level 6 dungeon.
So, what do I do against
this
one? This
is a better weapon than a cantrip. The spell from this wand can
cut down
enemies.
How do I don't have enough bombs? I have a problem.
Do these guys get bombs?
Maybe. Let's find out. If they don't, I'm gonna have a real problem. Also, I really hope that the Dongos do not respond.
Oh, I'm almost certain they do.
I don't know, because I mean, like, they're a boss, right? Like, that's three of a boss.
Go down and check.
Fuck.
I shall try to use the last.
Oh, go down, go
yes,
down,
yeah,
down,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're done.
Oh, fuck off.
Four bombs, that's not nearly enough bombs.
It takes two to kill one?
Yeah.
I thought we were gonna catch up. It looks like we were gonna catch up.
If we're only one dungeon behind, I feel like that's not the worst. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. The moment,
you need to pay the guy to get more bombs in that last dungeon.
Fuck.
Oh, it was a bomb cache upgrade.
Fuck. Okay, never mind, it's not that.
See, if we that, do you remember where that was that we saw? We said it was in the last dungeon?
Yeah.
I feel like
it was in the previous dungeon.
Okay, something we might want to do then.
Fire.
Oh yeah. like this and the other one diminish cap if you set them on fire. I think they turn into skeletons. They're skeletons underneath.
What is this? What is happening? Is the world ending? Why are the monsters who live in the dungeons creeping out onto the ground? Hero, you must hurry. This might be a sign that Hyrule has fallen into the hands of the evil king.
King's wrath finally strike the land above. Still, it might be a good idea to take this chance to conquer the dungeons. The number of monsters in the labyrinths has
increased. Because it wandered out.
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
All of the things spawn less monsters. Oh, that's so cool.
What is the evil king's aim?
This is so not helpful at all. Ugh. We're killing the mummies to farm for bombs.
I was asking why there's a second G-shaped dungeon. Is they spell out the station of the radio station that you're receiving this from, St. Giga.
Yep.
I don't know if the second set of maps that they ran also did that.
I'm not sure. I think it spelled out something else. Oh, this is excruciating. Oh, is 8 our maximum number of bombs?
I think it might be. That's what we're supposed to do.
Okay. This is brutal.
Yeah, we should have gotten an upgrade.
Oh,
yeah.
Fuck. Okay, this is...
Oh man, it's Leonard Cohen, Zelda?
Yes.
Okay, come on. You can do it, Leonard Cohen. Zelda is playing.
In the district of the higher world, in a small kingdom, there was a mystical power which had been passed down for many generations. This secret was made of two halves, power and wisdom, which formed the golden triangle of the Triforce.
Are you above ground? Be sure to have all the following items today. 6 Triforce pieces, the blue candle, the bow, the magic boomerang, the raft, the flute, the ladder, the magic rod, and the white sword. If you're skilled, you may also have the ring, the magic shield, the arrow, the bow, the medicine, and others purchased or obtained.
Distracting his evil grip on the world. He succeeded.
The way determines. If you're behind it for the boomerang purposes is completely wrong. The way it determines if you're behind it for using the boomerang is just completely wrong. Oh, right.
Okay, so now you can go through this bit and we can actually start getting to the...
Is the 6th Triforce piece in
the magic rod, not the magic rod.
You have only a few minutes left.
That doesn't help us. That doesn't even slightly help us. Okay, so we need a key.
Oh yeah, there's a key we could only get.
Oh yeah,
fighting,
right.
So yeah.
Okay, so let's hustle. We're not gonna finish this dungeon, but I wanna
get as far through it so that it's less little bit.
Exactly.
Zero.
Oh, and we can teleport to it now, right? Because we have the flutes?
Yeah.
Okay, great, awesome.
The boomerang's power is back to normal. Dark clouds thicken and cover the land. You must hurry.
Funny how much later 2D Zeldas we use these enemies, but like we
but less
them.
Frustrating, yeah. I'm so not used to them being bullshit.
No, combat's never good in the 2D Zeldas compared to some of the other.
It's way better than this.
But yeah, this is
excruciating.
I'd say it's probably best in Minish Cap, because Minish Cap is in general the most like polished of the 2D Zeldas.
Oh god, and we don't have the magic boomerang anymore.
Before my eyes. Can it be? It is the evil king.
Oof. Keep slipping a little bit more behind each time.
Hero, the time nears when the evil king will approach this
world. Yeah,
we're
most
above.
Of the way through that dungeon.
I can see it. That fiend. He is coming. The monsters of the dungeon's lower terrain on the above ground are but an omen of this. Hero, do not fail to return to the fight. Otherwise, the battle of today will become meaningless. So, we'll meet again.
No. No, we can't.
Yeah,
we
we're probably going to lose this, the way things are going. Yeah, we're at the final chapter after this, and yeah. So we end a half dungeons to do? Yikes. Switch it over to... So definitely coming close to the end. Yeah, the four dungeons in one week thing I think is going to be hard. Like, we're almost done this one. But we still have to travel through it. Plus find the other two, or other three. It's going to be tough. I'm not sure what we're going to be doing after we finish this set. We've got one more week of BS Zelda. Hopefully I'll manage to beat SOS during that time. And we'll see more of Seaman. I think we might keep Seaman around until we're done evolving Seaman. One of the versions lets you replay the fourth week as many times as you want. I don't know which version this is. Keep stream weird. one of the versions lets you replay the fourth week as many times as you want. I could see them doing that. Like, you wouldn't have the audio hints for the last week. Maybe it's three dungeons plus boss? Yeah, I don't know. I imagine, like, just that the last dungeon will have Ganon in it or something. And I feel like there's a lot of optional stuff we're missing. Like, there was the guy who wanted the strongest sword.
I didn't get the bomb bag. So, like, we were really slow at this partially because I've never played Zelda 1 before, but, like, this is, you know, this is meant for people who have played Zelda 1, and that's why this is, like, a different map.
Yeah.
So, you couldn't replay this, but they did rerun it a lot. Some of the others might have been replayable, but not this one.
Oh yeah, St. Giga is 6 levels.
Maybe it's only...
You walked into a place with... Oh, that was a stronger shield. It looked the same as
our
current
shield. It looked like
the
same shield. Yeah, I thought we already had that one. Yeah, I'm definitely interested to see what next week looks like.
See Ganon before him.
And honestly, like, this is what's exciting about this, you know? This is, like... This is an old, familiar game, but after, you know, you're still going, oh, what's going to happen next week? That's like, that's...
Yeah, no, it's like,
you know,
an interesting
it's teasing
remix.
Something interesting.
Yeah, I wonder, like, maybe what they'll do, since, yeah, it is 6 letters for St. Giga.
Hmm.
Maybe it's going to be something other than a dungeon and the fight against Ganon, and it'll give us a chance to catch up.
Maybe?
They do seem to be trying to sort of pace this so that... it gives people a chance to catch up because they can't do difficulty levels and you can't just wait for people to get good because it's only 4 hours. They're definitely trying their best to sort of rubber band it through hints and such and through some of the designs of the spells and events that happen to give you a chance to beat it at the end. It's really like it's an interesting design challenge trying to make something that's timed but also like one-time play. Where there isn't sort of that ability to just, like, grind on it and get good the way you could in a roguelike or something else with Chromadath.
I mean, I think also, like, you're probably supposed to, you know, if you fail this first broadcast, it's probably not that big of a problem as far as they're concerned. But it is supposed to be, like, a bit of a challenge.
Yeah.
And
it definitely is.
And, like, I'm sure they already had plans to rebroadcast it because that's exactly what they did. They reran this one in particular a lot.
I can see why. Like, I would definitely, if we failed it this time, I would want to give it another go.
For sure.
Knowing what we do. I have to say I wish there was a Satellaview version of a later Zelda. Like, even Link to the Past has some pretty rough edges. Which I know is kind of blasphemy, but it's kind of interesting.
Oh, no, it has a lot of rough edges.
I'm sure a lot of people consider that to be their favorite Zelda.
Yeah, because it's the first Zelda they played.
I don't think that's... people from my generation played 1, 2, and played Ocarina of Time. But I'm all for the weird Zeldas.
Yeah.
This is probably my third favorite now.
This is definitely up there with weird Zelda.
Fourth so far. I'm still sort of making my way through the Zeldas in a really weird, haphazard manner. Because I grew up with a Master System, not a NES. So I could talk about Golvelius on the Master System. Which is, imagine Zelda with kind of like endless runner auto-advancing dungeon stages. That's Golvelius.
Yeah, that looked really weird.
Super, super strange. Okay. And definitely not as good.
Yeah, I think this is a good point to back it
in. Yep, so we'll be back next week with the final episode of Real Time Game Stream. I was suggesting that we keep Seaman until we...
I was going to suggest the same thing, like start every stream with maybe a day of Seaman, because there's a lot more to go.
Yeah, no, there's definitely a lot more, and it just gets weirder.
Lots of weird invasive questions.
Yeah, it gets weirder and ruder as it goes.
Cool.
But yeah, we'll figure out what else we're doing after this. We've got a few different ideas. We have a big list. We'll just figure out what makes the most sense.
Yep.
So thanks a bunch for watching us again.
Yeah, thanks for joining.
Oh, also, if you want to pick up They Bleed Pixels, my game, it's like two something right now until like Monday afternoon, so it's super cheap on Steam right now.
It's a good intense precision platformer.
Yeah, if you want a really hard platformer with a little girl with claws,
all the important things.
We've got you covered. Till next time.
Thanks.